For many of us, Leonardo DiCaprio will forever remain Jack from Titanic, the romantic guy of every girl's dream. He only recently received an Oscar, but he is considered one of the best actors of his generation. Besides his unusual friendship with Kate Winslet and the fact that he almost exclusively dates Victoria's Secret models, we barely know anything about his life. In this video, we will show you how this intelligent man is trying to change the world and all unknown aspects of his life. Leo was born on November 11, 1974 in Los Angeles. His mother, Irmelin Inderbirken, was born in Germany, while his father, George DiCaprio, is half Italian and half German. The couple divorced when Leo was only 1 year old. His father, George DiCaprio, is a writer and a publisher. In the 1970s, he was an active member of the Bohemians and a distributor of the realm of underground comics, presenting a lot of prohibited content. Leo's dad was the one who had the key role in his career. He encouraged him to act and introduced him to an outstanding Polish sculptor, Stanisław Szukalski, whom he treated as a grandfather. Leo even claimed that Szukalski shaped him artistically. And as a tribute to this artist, Leo recently produced a fascinating documentary called Struggle, The Life and Lost Art of Szukalski, which can be seen on Netflix. If you haven't already watched it yet, we definitely strongly recommend it. DiCaprio not only is an actor and a promoter of art, but also a leading Hollywood ecologist, which he showcases whenever he gets the chance. For example, he devoted his speech when he received his long-awaited Oscar for his role in the movie The Revenant to mostly global warming. Many claim that he should receive another award just for the speech he gave. He then stated, "Our production needed to move to the southern tip of the planet just to be able to find snow. Climate change is real. It is happening right now. It is the most urgent threat facing our entire species. We need to work collectively together to stop procrastinating. We need to support our leaders around the world who don't speak up for the big polluters, but those who speak up for all of humanity." And that's not all. Imagine that DiCaprio only rides eco-friendly cars, like the hydrogen fuel cell Toyota Prius, or luxury sports cars, and of course the hybrid Frisker Karma, for which the actor paid $100,000 for, which is equipped with solar panels also. In 2013, Leo, together with Venturi Automobiles, became the co-owner of the team that created the eco-friendly electric racing car for Formula E. Leo also lives an environmental-friendly home. His ecological apartment, which he bought in 2008 for $10 million, is made of renewable materials, and the energy used in it comes mainly from solar panels. The actor even said that the environmentalist in him is his second profession. Leo is a member of many pro-ecological organizations, including the Worldwide Fund for Nature, Global Green USA, or International Fund for Animal Welfare. Since 1998, he has been managing his own organization, the Leonardo DiCaprio Foundation, which supports projects around the world that build climate resiliency, protect vulnerable wildlife, and restore balance to threatened ecosystems and communities. In order to collect funds for this organization, the actor often organizes interesting auctions with well-known supporters for the cause, like Elton John's private concerts auction, expeditions to Africa with the Prince of Monaco, and even selling Andy Warhol pieces. DiCaprio also makes appearances and gives speeches at conferences and meetings regarding environmental protection. For example, in 2014, as a UN Messenger of the Peace Summit, he gave a speech on problems caused by climate change, or in Davos in 2016, when during a controversial and widely commented speech he called the greed of the coal and oil industry. And of course, he doesn't hold back his cash when it comes to ecological activities. In 2016, during a private audience with Pope Francis, he wrote out a fat check for the ecological charities, although the amount was not disclosed. It is speculated, however, that he donated $1 million to save Seychelles. This was the first public payment for the environmental protection. Besides that, in 2016, he donated $15 million to two organizations for the development of renewable energy, and $3 million for saving the tigers in Nepal, and $7 million for ocean protection projects. And check this out, did you know that DiCaprio only smokes e-cigarettes and has never used drugs? So in order to prepare for his role in the movie The Wolf of Wall Street, he had to ask for advice from experts in this field. That powder that you saw in the movie was just powdered vitamin B. Do you think that Leonardo DiCaprio can change the world? What do you think about his non-acting projects? We would love to know your opinions. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more movies like this one.